Hey, this is Ben from Harrison. We're going to show you some new features of Mixbus version 3.2 today. This is right on the heels of Mixbus version 3.1 that we came out with a few weeks ago. We've got two really cool new features to show you. One of them is our export analysis window that pops open after you export a track, and the second one is our drum character plugin, which is a brand new addition to our character bundle, and it works on drums, as you might imagine. So let's first quickly look at this new feature, the export analysis window. So I'm going to export my session to an audio file, and I've got the file named. I'm going to click this button that says Analyze Exported Audio, and now when I click Export, it runs through the session, and after it's done, it normalizes the session, which I've asked it to do, and then it pops open an export analysis report. And this dialog gives me something that I really want when I'm making a mix. It gives me confidence that I've exported what I thought I was exporting. When we talk about Mixbus giving you better sounding mixes, everything we do in Mixbus is focusing on helping you make better mixes. And part of that is having this confidence when the mix is done that you are up to standards, either broadcast engineering type standards or just sound quality standards. This gives you a chance to double check everything you've done and make sure that it makes sense. So I'm going to quickly go over some of these features. On the top left corner, you see a reading of my peak sample value, which is 0 dBFS because I told it to normalize all the way to 0 dBFS for this particular session. And below that, it tells me the true peak value. In this case, it's also 0.0. The true peak is an oversampled measurement of the intersample peaks that happen in the reconstructed audio signal. And so normally that would be a little bit higher than the peak of the digital peaks, but in this case it's the same. And then it tells me how much normalization gain was applied to my mix to get it up to 0.0 dBFS. Now the second part that you're looking at is a histogram showing me how many times each of these loudness values occurred in my mix. So I see there's a tall cluster near minus 13, right around maybe minus 14 loudness units. And then there's another cluster sort of down here in this minus 20 to 23. So the minus 23 is the quiet part. That's this sort of a quiet bridge part of this song. But overall, we get an integrated loudness, an average loudness of minus 14.9 LUFS. Now the LUFS scale is a European broadcast engineering specification that you can look up and learn more about. But it's based on psychoacoustic loudness measurements, and we also can tell a loudness range. So you see this mix has a relatively wide 9.8 loudness unit range. And I can compare these numbers to other mixes. So if I import a WAV file to Mixbus and then run it through this analysis, I can compare my mix to the loudness and the loudness range of that other mix. Now, we also have a view of the waveform, and I can change the scaling of that waveform and the view mode. But you'll also see some light yellow lines. These indicate the peak loudness values during my track. So if I want to audition those points, I can skip around to each of the loud parts of the song and therefore give myself some confidence that I've made the mix that I think I'm making. So when I move down to the bottom portion, you see a spectrogram across the length of the export, and this gives me an idea of the energy in each frequency throughout my mix. And I can also compare that to other mixes if I import those tracks. So that's the new export analysis tool. The second new feature that we've added for Mixbus 3.2 is an excellent new plugin. This new plugin is called the XTDC drum character, and I'm going to make a video specifically for this plugin. Now, I'll give you a very quick introduction to it now. I'll loop a little bit of audio, and what you're seeing here is the attack and tail portion of my drum hits. And the gold part of this drum hit is affected by the golden EQ, and the green part of the drum hit is affected by this other EQ. And you'll recognize these shapes from the character bundle. All the tools are similar, so I can have two bands of equalization, basically a low and a high, but they're being applied to the attack and the tail portion of the sound. And what that provides me is a tool to take a kick drum that for example, was a little too muddy, I can boost the beater sound in the attack portion so that it has more clarity. And then I can maybe boost the low end on the tail to give it more oomph. And by manipulating what I'm adding and subtracting from the attack and the tail, I can dramatically change the sound of this kick drum or tom or snare drum without replacing the drum. I'm still keeping all the nuances and the sounds exactly as the drummer played them, but we're changing the character of those drums to fit into our mix better. So those are two of the cool ways that we have improved Mixbus for version 3.2. We'll have more details about both of those features coming out in separate videos, but this is just a quick introduction.